I gonna do with you? Huh? Oh, hello. I'll be with you in just a moment. It appears that someone had dropped this adorable pet boot at my doorstep. And, well, I really can't tell if it's asleep or just resting. Or maybe it's pining. Yeah, it's pining. Pining for the fjords. Yeah. Well, if you give me just a moment, I'm gonna find a nice little home over here on the shelf for this little fella. Or gal. Not really quite sure. Alright, and I'll be right with you. Just pardon me a moment, won't you? Okay. I think it'll be happy there for the time being until we can find it a new home. Are you interested in a pet boot? I got a little note with it. It said something along the lines of, "No, I'm no longer able to care for it. It really needs a mate. And its name is Spot." Spot. Who would ever call a pet boot Spot? Marianne, maybe. Clyde. But Spot? It seems quite demeaning, don't you think? Anyway, thank you very much for stopping by. My name is Dave. I am the sole proprietor of this fine establishment, the Innsmouth Thrift Shop, which is located not that very far from the docks in the bay, right near the marsh fishery. And a couple doors down from both the esoteric order of Dagon and one of the tin foil hat society's outposts. And boy, let me tell you about the tin foil hat society. They are a bunch of nosy little buggers, always coming around here into my shop saying that they're browsing. I don't really trust them at all. There's no nefarious activities that we engage in here. No, not at all. All of our items are lifted from, acquired from tourists and visitors and folks like that. So I can't imagine why anyone would think we're up to no good. It's preposterous. But anyway, you look vaguely familiar. Yeah. Did I happen to see you shopping in here before? Or did I perform an experimental surgery on you? I can't help but notice some of those exquisite body modifications you have, which are a signature of the work performed at Arkham Sanitarium. Did I happen to perform your surgery? Or was it Corvus or the professor? Maybe someone else? All right, well, it's a pleasure to see you again. Perhaps you'll have to forgive me. My old fish brain isn't quite what it used to be when I was a wee little tadpole swimming around the bay near Devil's Reef. So, what brings you here today? Just looking to browse? Okay, that's fine. Well, why don't I just go through and show you some of the new things that we have for sale here. And since we are a thrift shop, they are quite inexpensive and affordable. Okay. Well, let's see. How about I show you some of the apparel that we have? Okay. Got a few new articles of clothing in. And something very, very interesting. Just a moment. I have this really nice robe or a cape. It's quite strange, actually. There was an individual came in here looking to donate it. He said there was a lot of mayhem going on in the streets, and they just, as they were running along, they noticed this pile of ashes on the ground. And next to it was this robe, just laying there, and an amulet. I'll get to that amulet in a moment. So, well, if you're looking for a nice cape, perhaps, you know, for whatever formal occasion, might require a cape like this. I'm willing to part with it for, let's see, $7.95. Okay? So you can think about that. I'll just put it back, and I'll be right back with you. I might as well show you that amulet that I was just talking about. Give me a moment. There you go. This is quite an exquisite piece of jewelry. I don't really know what kind of language it's in. You can see there are some inscriptions. And it looks like a little eye in there, some kind of stone. And like I said, the individual that donated it, you know, they just, I guess, wanted to show their support for, you know, the little shop that I run here. So, this is available for, $12.50, okay? But if you buy multiple items, you'll get a 10% discount. Alright, does that sound good? Okay. But yeah, just take a look at that. Little inscriptions there. It's a nice, intricate work right there. It has a really nice, see, it's like that. There's this little amulet. I have no idea what it does, but, so, see, you could wear this with probably almost anything. Has those red and black bands, a rope, gold trim. It really would accent any type of suit. Or if you purchase that robe, that cape, you know, it would match real well with that. anything red or black that you're wearing, you know, this would really pop out. So you can think about that, all right? Just a moment, my friend. I'll be right back. Allow me to show you something else that I recently acquired. This black leather wallet. I'm not really sure who it belongs to. Take a look. Oh, look at that. There's a picture of me in there. Oh, that's my driver's license. Just a moment. That's my credit card. Oh, you'll have to forgive me. This is my wallet. I was wondering where it got to. Of course, it's not for sale. But, all right. Anyway, put this away. Okay. So, how would I continue to show you some of the more apparel that we have? Okay, my friend. Just a moment. Over here. I have for sale this really nice brown robe. It has a little hood. Unfortunately, it doesn't have a waist band or anything like that to keep it secure and closed. But if you're, looking for a nice addition to your wardrobe, or maybe you're looking to join a cult, this might be the robe for you. Would probably make you stand out among all your other cultists, you know, wearing this one, because most cult members wear black robes. That seems to be the latest thing. But this, yeah, this is really nice. So I'll let this go for about $5.75. So you can think about that, my friend. Okay? Just give me a moment. Let me put this back. Here's another robe that I have for sale here. It's a classic black robe. So like I said, if you're looking to join a cult and their dress code is that they require you to wear a black robe, well, here you go, my friend. So listen to that. Really nice quality material. Let me tell you, today's world, they really don't skimp on the quality in these cult robes. You know, not like the cults back in the day. And as you can see, it's fully in one piece. It's not open like that brown robe. Has a nice little tie here in the front. See that? And, of course, if you happen to wear a suit and a tie underneath, or an amulet, this little V-neck, you know, let your tie show through, or your amulet, whatever it might be. Nice. Long sleeves, too. So I'll let this one go for $11.82, because it's a full piece. It's a little more pricey than the brown robe. Okay? So you can think about that. So you can put this back. I'll be right back. Let me show you this other one. This is some kind of jumpsuit of some sort. There was an individual who brought this in. I forget where they were. They said they were from. Oh yeah, they said they were from a vault. And they said some number. I forget what number they said. They seemed to be in a hurry. They had a dog with them. And they had another companion. It was a robot, something, if I'm not mistaken. But, they donated this. You know, that's where we get most of the items that we acquire from donations. If you're looking for a vault suit, I guess is what you would call it, you might want to consider picking this up. I'll let this go for $16.27. No, $15.94. Yeah, it's a little beat up, but. Okay, you can think about that. Let me put this back. All right. Is there anything that strikes your fancy? We have some new albums, some books. Oh, we have a PS3, a video game system. Just a moment. It comes with two controllers. We have some video games that go with it. And it has the cords, the power cords as well. So, I've tested it, and it works. Just give me a moment. Here is the red controller. You can hear all the little buttons. So you know it works. I tested it. Do you like to play video games? I sure do. I own a PS4 myself. Yeah, see here? All the little buttons. They work. None of them are stuck. I love that sound. We actually use video game controllers as part of our treatment sessions up at the sanitarium. Yeah. Well, the controllers work. Everything that we sell here at the thrift shop, or I sell here, it's always tested. So there you go. It's one of the controllers. And here is the PS3 unit itself. Very good quality. I would say it's lightly used. So I'm willing to sell the unit itself for $45.81. But because I think I might have seen you in here before buying a few things, if you're a return customer, or maybe you're a patient of ours, I'll give you a 10% discount, okay? So, PS3 unit. And like I said, I do have a video game collection, but that's in the other part of the thrift shop. This part, the section that you're here in now, this is more of the unique items. The majority of items that we sell are in the main part of the thrift shop where you came in. This is kind of more of the new stuff and the things you might not generally find in the other part of the store. Okay, let me just show you some of the other things I have for you. I have this really nice backpack. What's that? A rucksack? Okay. I didn't know backpacks had particular names, but yeah, this one is really nice. It has the straps here to keep it secure and closed. It has another has the drawstrings. Keep the main part closed. It has a little zipper compartment right here. Let's see if I can. You'll have to forgive me, being a deep one. My fingers aren't quite as nimble and dexterous as you humans. So. But yeah, see if I can get this to close. There you go. So that works. Rather do like that sound. Okay. And it also has a little compartment here. Side as well. nice little strap where you can carry it or hang it up. Nice, strong, padded straps, shoulder straps. They're adjustable as well, which is great. And another compartment right here. So you can put all kinds of things in here on your little excursions into the wherever it might be that you like to go excursing. I'm not much of an excursor myself, but I'm a simple fish, really. I like to keep to myself, stay home, venture out once in a while, you know, when I'm not doing my work up at the sanitarium. I like to get out into nature once in a while. Yeah. It's nice. Rucksack for sale. I'm willing to let this go for... How does $13.18 sound? Sound like a good deal? Let me put this back. It's a really nice one. Okay. We also have a collection of nice hats. We have this Russian military hat. I think it's at ushanka, if I'm not mistaken. You have to pardon my English. English is not my first language. That would be Valahian. Stuff like that. So yeah, this is nice. Ushanka. There was a Russian gentleman that came in here looking to sell it. I'm not sure if you can hear that fine quality. Fur. Oh, this is really nice. There is a Russian gentleman that brought this in. Donated it, of course. There's the little emblem on the front. So I'm willing to sell this for I would say $6.72. Okay. So you can think about that. It's really nice. Keep you warm in the winter months. also have this top hat for sale. It's a really nice piece. Listen to that quality. I believe it's real leather, too, in case that matters to you. Nice strong brim. It has these little United States of America 5-cent replica coins with the buffalo on it. It's kind of neat. But yeah. What do you think? Like one of those old Western Mavericks. So, because of the quality and the leather, I'm willing to sell this one for $11.32. Okay. And don't forget, if you happen to be a patient or return customer, you get a 10% discount. And if you buy multiple items, you'll get an additional 10%. So that's 20% total. Does that sound good? You know, I'm not really looking to profit. You know, I'm not looking to become a millionaire. Just enough I can pay the bills and treat myself to a nice steak dinner once in a while. All right, so you think about that. And I'll get some more goodies to show you. Okay, my friend. I also have this other top hat. This one is not quite as good quality as the leather one I just showed you. This one's more felt. It has like a cardboard material inside. So I'll be willing to sell this one to you for $4.92. Okay. It has a nice little bow tie or ribbon right there, however you want to say that. Nice all the way around, nice accent. So this would be good. If you're looking to go out on the town, you know, to an opera, or maybe, you know, whatever it might be. There you go. Nice little top hat. That's a nice, really soft texture to it. Maybe you just want to buy it just so you could do this to help you relax. Bring it back to your room. You know, if you're a patient at the sanitarium, just, maybe you don't like pets, and you could just hold this and make that nice sound to help you relax, calm your mind. Just like that. Okay, I'll be right back. As I mentioned earlier, we do have quite a variety of books for sale out near the front with all the other items, the majority of everything. This is something recent that we acquired. At least I think so. I don't remember if we offered this before. This is called The Ultimate Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy by Douglas Adams. 5 novels in 1 outrageous volume. So, apparently, this is somewhat of an atlas and a guide, as it says, that will help you navigate the universe, get you to wherever you need to go. So this very well could be yours too. All the books that we sell go for $1. Okay? I actually was perusing this myself the other day. And I came upon this one section. Not sure I'll be able to find it. But some poetry in here. Some really nice poetry, too. Here we go. It's called Vogon Poetry. Some of the most beautiful poetry I've ever heard in my fishy life. Oh, freddled grunt buggly. Isn't that beautiful? Thy micturations are to me as plurtled gabble blotchets on a lurgid bee. Or lurgid, I don't know how you say that. Group, I implore thee, my funting turling drones, and booptiously drangle me with crinkly bindle wordles, or I will rend thee in the gobble warts with my blurgle crunching. See if I don't. That's beautiful stuff. Maybe one day I'll get to see a Vogon. There you go. So, $1 if you're interested. I got a couple more books to show you. Be right back. I have this book. It's not a complete fiction of H.P. Lovecraft, but if you ask me, it's not really a work of fiction at all. It's actually a compendium of real-life events, but it was, I guess you would say it was pawned off as fiction so as not to arouse suspicion or to upset the masses, I guess you might say. But all kinds of real-life accountings, strange, creatures, beings. There's a story in here called The Color Out of Space, the case of Charles Dexter Ward, the dream quest of unknown god of the strange high house in the mist, Pickman's model, The Call of Cthulhu. That's one of my favorites. That is a story of my best friend, Kevin. In case you don't know, that's Cthulhu's name in English, Kevin. And of course, you know, Cthulhu works as a doctor now up at the sanitarium, thanks to the professor and the work of Charlie Carl going down into the depths of the Pacific to rescue Kevin from his underwater prison. So this is a dollar as well. You might unearth some secrets reading this. There's a lot of locations that you can go exploring here in Innsmouth and in Arkham that have a lot of stories to tell. Just be careful walking around some of these districts in Innsmouth at night. I wouldn't advise it, okay? Not all of my kind take to strangers or are welcoming of strangers and outsiders, okay? So, just need to let you know. Yeah, $1 if you're interested, okay? And by the way, H.P. Lovecraft, he's a patient up at the sanitarium. He was reanimated. Speaking of compendiums and manuals, I have this for sale. The Monster Manual. This is another little compendium of all kinds of real life monsters and creatures that you might encounter in the world. So if you're an adventurer, and maybe you're looking to pick up that rucksack, maybe that amulet, pick this up too, and you can go monster hunting. Maybe find some treasure, and of course, gain some experience and level up. Very important. Lots of interesting creatures in this. There's a slod. A magmin. A manticore. A drow. Orcs. And so on and so forth. So this is $1 as well. Okay. So I'll be right back. That's the Monster Manual. I also have this bag of dice. Very important for every adventurer. 20-sided die, 6-sided, 4-sided, 10, 8, 1, 2, I think that's about it. You can't go adventuring in the world without your trusty 20-sided die. You never know when you're going to need to make a saving throw. That could determine whether you're going to live or die. Escape a trap. If you call it sneaking, etc. So, lots of different colors too. Red, blue, green, white, black, some transparent ones. I'll sell the individual dye for a nickel, or the whole bag for $2. So it's your choice. Okay. So that's the bag of dice. I also have this bag of triggers. Let me show you. I believe there are 72 gun triggers in here, just like this one. I'm not really sure what kind of gun. Shotgun, rifle, handgun, minigun, BFG, who knows? There's another one. So if you're, in need of some triggers, here's a hell of a whole lot of them for you. Each trigger sells for a quarter a piece, or you can take the whole lot for $5. Okay? I also have these blocks, and I believe they are blocks of the old ones. These are, if I'm not mistaken, and I'm not a scholar, but they are signs of protection from the old ones, ancient beings that predate mankind, that come from other dimensions, like Kevin, Cthulhu, who was banished from his home world. I'm not really sure of the whole drama behind all that. I'm not sure if he ran away from home, or if he didn't agree with his parents and how they, and his upbringing. But he ended up here on Earth, imprisoned at the bottom of the Pacific. Maybe he's a escaped felon. I don't really know. But if you purchase these, they are said, if you are able to invoke their power by pronouncing the key used to bring them to life, that they'll create a protective barrier around you and protect you from the old ones. Of course, course, you can choose not to use them for their intended purpose and just enjoy the sounds that they make as a meditative device. Some nice sounds. Hear that? That's really nice. Just have to be careful not to clack them together too hard. There you go. These are for sale for $4.37. Okay. Right back. As I mentioned earlier, we do have some albums for sale. All of our albums sell for $2.75. Okay. Don't forget about those discounts I mentioned. All right, my friend. Here's just a few recent additions. This is King Diamond Abigail. You can see it's a picture disc. I also have Alice in Chains Dirt. Let me tell you some of the names of the songs on that King Diamond album. It's the Funeral, Arrival, A Mansion in Darkness, The Family Ghost, of course, Abigail, the title track, The Black Horseman. Here is Alice in Chains Dirt, Them Bones, Damn That River, Rain When I Die, Down in a Hole, Sick Man, Rooster, Hate to Feel, Anger Chair, and Wood. Next up, we have, I don't really know what band this is. Don't even know what that is. Like a rib cage, maybe. Let's see, who is this? No, it's the band Tool. I think the name of the album is Undertow. Here's a cute little piggy with a bunch of forks underneath of them. Intolerance, Sober, Bottom, Swamp Song, Disgustipated. And next, this is Metallica. I'm sorry. Oh, Metallica. Right. Yeah, you'll have to forgive me. This is Ride the Lightning. And we have Fight Fire with Fire. ride the lightning, for whom the bell tolls, fade to black, creeping death, and the call of Cthulhu, but they spell Cthulhu's name wrong. Don't know why. And then one of the next albums we have for sale is by the band Slayer, and it's called Rain in Blood. Very interesting artwork on the cover. Let's see. We have Angel of Death, Piece by Piece, Necrophobic, Criminally Insane, and Raining Blood, and a bunch of others. So, all for sale, if you're interested. Okay? Just a moment. I also have this brown shoe for sale. Just the one. It's the left shoe. I'm not really sure what size it is. But if you are in need of a left brown shoe, this might be what you need, what you're looking for. Just listen to that quality. Can see the sole still in pretty good shape, lightly worn. So I am willing to sell this for, well, all of our shoes sell for $3.15 each. But because this one is missing the right shoe, well, it makes it extremely valuable. This one will sell for, I'm willing to part with this one for $6.09. Okay, my friend? So, shoes that are missing the other, left or right of the pair, extremely valuable, hard to find. So keep that in mind if you're into collecting shoes. Okay. Let me put this back. I also have for sale this nice pair of leather gloves. Whether you're looking to wear them for cold weather, maybe you have a motorcycle, or maybe you're looking to acquire some items yourself at night, These will be very handy for almost any situation like that, where you need to protect your hands from the elements, or keep your fingerprints where they shouldn't be. Really nice leather gloves. These are the same kind that we use in our treatment sessions up at the sanitarium, which you may be familiar with. So all of our accessories like this, especially gloves, are inexpensive. These pair sell for $3.24. Alright, my friend. So some leather gloves, if you're interested. I almost forgot to mention one of the new items that we received when we got that ushanka Russian hat. Just give me a moment. We also have for sale, or I also have for sale, this AK-47. It's in good working condition from what I understand. It's been modified to take special kind of bullets. I don't have those, but maybe you're looking to go hunting. Or maybe you're, you know, for some protection out on the streets of Innsmouth here at night. You might be interested in this. Most of the weapons that we sell, like this, sniper rifles, rocket launchers, mini nukes, they usually sell in the range from $7.16 all the way up to $8.74. So this is going to sell for $8.03. It's a good working condition. You can see. So yeah, if you're in need of an AK-47, here you go. Very inexpensive price. Don't forget the discount. Except we do not honor 5-finger discounts. Forgot to mention that earlier. I also have for sale this wireless keyboard. You can see the wire has been cut off, which of course, that's how they make wireless keyboards. The only thing is, space bar is missing. I'm not sure if you are familiar with the spacebar thief, I think is what they call it, him or her. But space bars all across the world, even different parts of the multiverse, are disappearing from keyboards everywhere. So if you happen to go into a shop that sells space bars, report them to the authorities. They're probably selling stolen space bars. But this wireless keyboard is in great condition otherwise. I'm personally not a fan of keyboards because of, you know, my genetics. My hands don't really take too well to keyboards. I do wish they made a keyboard with bigger keys. That would be more accommodating to my kind. There you go. Nice keyboard. Okay. Well, I think I've kept you long enough. I have time for one more item, and then I'm gonna have to close shop. Okay? So just bear with me. Actually, I lied. I have time for two more items. First is this. Strange device. This was found in an old mansion up on a hill. People that used to live there said they would hear rats in the walls. I guess this is some kind of drill. Makes a really nice sound. We use some just like it up at the sanitarium for some of our treatment sessions. All of our tools sell for around $5.67. So if you're interested in this one, this one sells for $5.11. Really nice sound. So relaxing, calming. Okay. Let me show you the last item that I have. This is a safety cone, but if you notice, it has these strange symbols, just like symbols on those wooden blocks. I'm not really sure the purpose of this cone. I'm assuming you would place it down on the ground whenever there was an elder god or an old one nearby. Again, I don't really know. We have one just like it at the sanitarium, and we'll use it from time to time in our treatment sessions. There was an individual that came by who donated this. Actually looks just like the one that we have at the sanitarium. Okay. Well, my friend, that's gonna be it. Please feel free to stop by anytime. We're always updating our inventory. So if you are interested in acquiring something that we might not have, stop back another time. You never know what we might have to offer. Okay, thanks again for dropping by. And see you around sometime. Don't be a stranger. Maybe I'll see you up at the sanitarium. If you're a patient, that is. Take care for now. Bye-bye. Not Sathio Kota. In the Kondes in the Tuna Koti Sada. Kindasanda Kota Sindeko. Sinde Kondesanda Kontala. Kame Sinde Kola Tasima. Sato Yagato Sonda Chunda Yagato Sonda Kunda Sel Yagato Soko Fana Sindeka Sana Chunda Kofil Sindala. Chinda kona sienda chota, chakunda chanda chote, chinda kona.